paint may never dry on a new mural in downtown Duncan after city council gave the order to wash the work of art from its urban canvas. Last month, an up-and-coming artist was hired to transform a cement barrier in a parking lot into something beautiful. Many in Duncan say the young painter did just that. But city council stepped in when it found the proper paperwork was not filled out to create the mural. CTV's Scott Cunningham has more.
I did the green, and then I did blue on top.
All the colors of the rainbow brought it together, but red tape might bring it down.
To see this covered up would definitely hurt me a little bit.
A month ago, a local hotel commissioned Cyrus Genier to transform an ugly cement block into something out of the ordinary.
It's so vibrant, and I love the flow of it.
Mm-hmm.
Many see his work as beautiful and are coming from up and down the island to snap photographs. The mural incorporates the word community, but does it illegally. Municipal paperwork was never filed to have the urban artwork approved.
To lose it would be devastating. Creatively, it would be, because this is a beautiful piece of artwork.
A city council vote which decided this mural must go was by no means unanimous. It split council right down the middle, an outcome which has many in the community saying this issue deserves a second look. While Cyrus's mural is multicolored, city bylaws are black and white. Councilors say they cannot pick and choose when to enforce them, but growing support for the artist has some on council ready to reconsider before the paint dries on their removal order.
How it was done to me is part of the problem. How we can fix it, therein lies the understanding of our community, that we as council have to sit down and talk with the people and say, what do we do?
With no answers yet, Cyrus is staying upbeat.
I think we're going to try and keep it up with a positive battle.
Vowing to lobby council by showing them the effect his work,
it is gorgeous, it is dynamic, it's colorful,
has on the people of Vancouver Island. Scott Cunningham, CTV News, Duncan.